Hello everybody, how's it going? Welcome back. People, today we're gonna be talking about something that I think is gonna help all of you when it comes to recording dialogue. This is a tip, something that I've been doing lately, and I think it's gonna help a lot of people that are recording dialogue, scripted dialogue, for any film or short film or anything like that. This is a script, and as you can see in my script, I have different colors, and I highlight different things, right? Well, in this script, for example, we have an interaction between one, two, three, we have interaction with three people. And why is this gonna be helpful? First of all, instead of looking at a boring page, you're looking at something that is colorful, right? So that right there is like a little bit more appealing to your eyes. So just think about it this way. If you're reading script, you're following the dialogue, right? You're mixing the dialogue. And why is good to have a script handy when you're recording dialogue, when you're mixing dialogue? It's important to know who's going to talk after. Like, you know, it's nice to know the pace. You know, like boom operators need to know the dialogue. Sound mixers also need to know the dialogue. Some directors and some script supervisors, they really want the actors to keep the same script. They follow the script, right? They don't want no ad-libs, no thing that they don't want to improvise anything. They want to keep the dialogue whatever the script says. And you gotta understand, sometimes there's more than one page, right? So these guys, actors, are remembering all these pages off their heads. So they're gonna be switching words and changing things, right? And forgetting lines. The script supervisor is gonna be taking care of that. Like he or she is gonna be in charge of having everything consistent. Everybody has to be on page, on the same page. And then if they're a mistake, they talk to the actors, so everybody's on the same page, right? But you as a mixer, it's also really nice to follow the dialogue so you know who's going to be talking, who's going to be exiting as a scene, right? So that's one thing I like to have this. I like to have these colors because I know I have color coded on my mixing board, on my sound recorder. So let's say there's a scene where you have three character members and they're all talking, but they don't talk at the same time. So there's one coming from the left, one coming from the left, and one coming from the right. So actor number one is just walking through frame and he just says one line. Hey, how's it going, guys? Or something like that. And then he goes out of the screen, right? I like to read the script so I know that there's nothing else that he's gonna be saying that I'm gonna be missing if I just put the fader down or the knob down, you know? So basically what I'm trying to say is whenever they exit the screen, I automatically close those tracks. So I'm not hearing them saying things and just be like just talking with somebody else, you know, because that's gonna go to your mix track. So I just bring it all down so they're out, and then I just keep my script ready in case they're gonna come back so I can fade them in, you know, like mix them as they go, as they come back and do things. So that's one thing I like to do, and that's why I like to have my script ready. And another thing is I like to be on top of things, because if the director or somebody asks me like, hey, did they say this line in this take, or they skipped it, and I'm like, I don't remember. That's why I like to follow the script. And then if they skipped a line, I make a note in my sound reports. And then if the director or the script supervisor goes like, yo, can you check if they said this line on this take? And I'm like, sure. And I already know if they skipped it or not because I made a note myself. Another thing that really happens when it comes to the script, names. Like when they're describing people and they're trying to say full names. In the last show we worked on, there was the name of the, and his name was some Italian thing, and they couldn't remember how they pronounce it, right? So I didn't make a note of it, so I had to go back in my files and remember how they said it, right? So they kept the consistency. Because imagine if in the master shot they said, I don't know, let's say Tolero, and it's Tolaro, and then, or something like that, you know, something as basic as that, and they just changed how they said it. Now it's gonna be all over the place, right? So they have to keep it consistent, so I had to go back and listen to what they said on the first one. Always keep an eye on names, like names of stores and names of people, because that's a thing that they might ask you. That's mainly why I like to keep the script ready, and that's why I always highlight it. Another thing why I like to have the script on me, because let's say you have a scene with 10 characters. I need to know which ones are speaking, so I have to allocate which ones are going to be wearing wires lavalier microphones and which ones we're going to catch them with the boom. Because I'm kind of limited on inputs right now. I'm using a Sound Devices 633. So with that guy, you can only have 4 or 5 lavs technically on your boom. You really have to think this through, you know, like you have 10 people, you need to allocate your microphones. Who is going to be wearing which ones and why? Another thing I recommend doing is watching blockings. And more than the blocking, just watching in general, like the whole movement, how is it going to go? Watch the set, what's happening, how many lights are they going to be doing. Maybe the boom operator is not going to be able to catch all of the lines with the boom, so that's why we use wireless, right? So they can catch those lines, and then maybe when we go up for coverage, that's when the boom gets in there. That's at least how I do things and how I've been learning to do these things, you know. Another thing that really helps me is that my boom operator, he's been on a lot of sets, so he knows these things, and then he tells me these things and I understand these things now, like, oh yeah, he's right, and things like that, you know. So always remember that this is a process of, it's a teamwork for all departments. You have to start with your own department. That's why I like to keep the script with me at all times, so I know what's happening, and I like to color code it because it's kind of fun. Because otherwise, it's just a boring, plain paper, and it's not fun. Well, I hope you guys like this tip. Let me know if it was helpful. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys around.